everyone and welcome to my channel. I hope you all are doing really, really well. It's been a while I have brought myself together and come in front of camera to shoot any video for my channel. But here I am. I thought let's just upload, something that will give you an update on my current pregnancy journey. And as you all know, I am around 38, 39 weeks pregnant. So very soon this little baby is going to come out. And I thought this is the best time to just quickly share a short update on how my pregnancy is going and what I've been doing so far last couple of weeks. So in this video, I'll be sharing with all of you an update on my pregnancy. And there is a very special surprise that came to me, which I would like to share with all of you. So I'll be inserting a clip of that as well when the surprise had come at my doorstep. So please do watch the video till the end. And if you like this video, do share a thumbs up as well as like and subscribe to my channel. It would really, really mean a lot to me. So in regards to the current pregnancy update, I think most of you would know that once we reach, the labor time, the checkups happen more frequently. It's every week now. And from the recent checkups that I've had with my doctor, we've had an internal checkup, we've had a sonography checkup, and everything seems to be okay for now, which is a good thing. Apart from that, I have also been asked to do COVID tests. So COVID test is required because I need a report with me which will prove that I am COVID negative, so that when I have to go to a hospital at the time of labor, I have a proof with me which shows that I am COVID negative, and that way they can get me admitted. But without that proof, it will be very difficult for the process to go on smoothly, and I will need a COVID negative or a COVID positive, whatever result it is, to show at the hospital at the time of labor. So in order to keep this result handy with me, I have to every week do tests once a week, because that test is valid for a week. So that's been happening last couple of weeks. I have been getting my COVID test done, and thankfully I've been negative. There have been no symptoms as such, so there was no chance or possibility of me being COVID positive, but this was just a formality that I am supposed to do. That was as well a completely different experience. I actually recorded the first time I went to do the test. Let me just share it with you all. So guys, hum ek vaccination center gaye. It was like a vaccination center as well as a place where tests are done. But unhone kaha they will not be able to do my test. That's because I do not have any symptoms or any sort of flu. They are only taking flu patients. तो मेरा टेस्ट वहाँ नहीं होगा. आई विल हैव टू गो टू अनदर प्लेस. लेट्स सी अगर वहाँ पे होता है कि नहीं. आई विल शो यू गाइस. निकल रहे घर के लिए. सो सक्सेसफुली टेस्ट हो गया एंड द रिजल्ट विल बी सेंट ऑन एन ईमेल, सो आई डोंट हैव टू कम बैक एंड कलेक्ट इट, व्हिच इज अ गुड थिंग. लेट्स सी व्हाट हैपेंस नेक्स्ट, बट नाउ वी आर हेडिंग होम. सी यू ऑल एट होम. सो गाइज, वी हैव कम होम नाउ आफ्टर डूइंग ऑल द टेस्ट. ऑनेस्टली माई नोज इज ट्विचिंग, क्योंकि ना दे हैड टू पुट दैट स्वॉब, डू अ नोज स्वॉब टेस्ट एंड देन द थ्रोट स्वॉब. सो So the first time when I went to do COVID test, the result came as inconclusive. And because it was inconclusive, we didn't know whether it's positive or negative. And what happened was that result wasn't valid. So I had to do it again. And, you know, going to the center and getting yourself tested is a pain in itself. But I had to pay as well if I have to do it again. And these were very expensive, these tests. So I was not prepared, and thankfully my doctor just excused me for that week, saying that next week onwards we'll require it, maybe this week we can skip. So then the week after I did another COVID test and that came out as negative, and that's the update so far. So I'll be doing another COVID test the coming week and just keeping a result handy with me, as in when I'll go to the hospital I'll require this. So that's it. I'm supposed to be doing squats So, I think a lot of you who are following me on Instagram would see how from the pictures that I've shared or whatever videos I share, reels that I upload, it is kind of tough with this big tummy to be able to walk around, move around, physically exert myself, but then having to do squats is another thing in itself, which is just doubling the whole pain. And along with the lower region of my tummy, I have got now my thighs also adding to it. So all of that is what I'm going through. I have to do squats daily. I have to also note down the movements of the baby after every meal. So that's what's going on right now. I am in this stage just waiting, and the wait doesn't seem to end. When the day will come, when this baby will come out. Honestly speaking, I'm very, very nervous too. I'm very anxious. I'm very worried because while I have to think of this baby, I have my other two babies who I need to make sure are comfortable, are safe, are taken care of, because I'm not sure if a lot of you are aware, due to the COVID norms, the rules of staying in the hospital have changed. So at the moment, it is working in such a way where, I'll have my husband over with me and he will be with me. He will not be allowed to leave the premises. So having no one else in my family, it is a challenge to understand how to go about with taking care of the other two kids, which is my dog, Cookie, and my daughter, 8-year-old daughter, Sophie. But thankfully, through God's grace, I have managed to make arrangements to keep Sophie and Cookie at a certain place, who will take care of them in my absence. So that's good. And I'm happy that I have that load off. But I'll still have that worry continuously in me. Just basically trying to figure out if okay, I'm trying to record something. Please, thank you. Okay. So I was saying that, that worry will definitely be there, but I don't know for how long also this will go on. I'm guessing 3 days, maybe 3-4 days. So whatever those days will be, I will have to adjust and I will have to just make sure things are okay with them too. But yeah, so that's there. Along with packing my hospital bag, I have their bags to pack as well, their stuff to pack as well, so that when they are away under the care of certain people, they have everything that they need, essentials that they need to be able to manage those 3-4 couple of days. So that's the update so far. I think that's about it when it comes to the pregnancy part of my life right now. And a very sweet surprise that came to my doorstep. I had recorded that event, but I couldn't share it for some reason. I was occupied, I was busy, but I have the clip with me, so I'm going to add that clip to this video, and that way you'll be able to see the surprise. And I think by now you must have known what it is from the title, but just the reaction and how it all turned out, it would be great to see it. So I've added that in this video. Please do take a look. Hello everyone, I want to show you all a very sweet surprise that came to my home today, this morning actually. Aur tab se maine waise ka waise hi rakha hua hai. I thought let me show you guys, and for that I wanted a proper time where I'm settled enough to be able to show you. So what I'm going to show you right now is a gift that I received. And I've got this from my cousins, my family, who are not living in Mumbai though, but they sent this very sweet gift for the baby to come, and I just can't wait to open it. I'm so excited, and I thought I will show it to all of you also. So I hope you all also enjoy and be a part of this sweet little moment that we are now trying to make. So everyone, this is what we have got. Show you
such a big box.
Yes, it's a very, very big box, and it has been kept at home waiting for the right moment to be unboxed. So we are going to do the unboxing of this box. It's basically a baby bassinet sent for the baby to come, and I feel so happy and grateful that I received such a gift from my family. And this is something that I didn't purchase till now, and I was waiting to, just find the right one. And I think through God, this just worked out in such a way that I got this as a gift. So I'm very, very, very excited to open this. And let's quickly unbox and start the unpacking. guys, so we finally managed to set it all up. It wasn't very difficult. There was an instruction manual sent along with it, and I'll quickly now show you all how does it look. So here it is, our little baby bassinet.
Cookies. I would put cookie inside.
Cookie is wondering, what's this?
Cookie inside.
Okay, so in case you guys are curious to know how exactly this works, okay, now that fell down. We're still trying to figure out how to do the top part of,
I think I got
the
it.
Cover part of it. But anyways, I'll just show the rest. So this is so super soft. Oh my god, it feels like velvet. Another good thing about this is, so if you see, this is the portion, but then there is an option to lift this part up. So when you lift it, like once the baby has done with, having milk, you don't want the baby to lie down immediately. So, you know, this part gets lifted. There is this option over here at the side. Show you all. So this is what comes along with this. So basically it allows you to adjust. And when you pull this part up, it acts like a recliner, you can say. And this is how the baby can sleep. And there is a place down as well to keep baby stuff. There is an option for the wheels to go on brake mode. And if you want it to be on moving mode, then you can, change it to moving mode. So this is the baby bassinet. Oh my god, this looks so cute. I'm so happy that we've got this and we'll be finally using it for the little one. Okay guys, one more thing. We managed to figure out the roof part of it. So here it is how it looks. It was actually very easy. You just had to spread it across the rim of the car. Mosquito net. And if I show you how it looks all the way, this is how it is. Komal and Kinka, if you guys are watching this video, we want to say a very big thank you from all of us, all three of us, Sophie, me, my husband, for you guys to send this to us. It was really, really very sweet and thoughtful of you to do it. And we are just so happy once we saw the whole thing and it looks perfect. It's adjustable, it can be folded, so it's perfect for our home. And it's super comfortable from what I can see. I'm sure the new baby is going to love it. But a very big thank you for this super lovely gift. I'm really, really happy that you guys thought of us and the baby and sent this across. Thank you so much. So lovely. Oh my god. I'm just so happy only looking at it. Can imagine the baby gonna be in it. Anyways, guys, in case you're curious to know from where we've got this, so as I just mentioned earlier too, this is a gift sent to us for the baby. And in case you're curious to know about the product itself, it's from the brand Star. It's from the brand Star and Daisy. And it's available on Amazon. So this is from where we've got ours. And I just can't wait for the little baby to get into it. But that's the detail about the product. So with that, I can end this video. But if you are watching my videos regularly and like what you see, then it would really, really be nice if you subscribe to my channel. Follow me on Instagram as well, because it's great to be connected there too. And do like and share if you can. See you all very soon in my next video. Till then, take care and bye bye.